and I have some amazing news. I came to New York on a dream. I knew it might take me a while, but all I've been hearing since I arrived is leave it right there on the pile. So today I woke up and decided it's time. Time to achieve, time to thrive, time to climb.
Miss March, tell us what happened.
Sometimes when you dream, your dream is just a guess. Sometimes when you work really hard, you don't know if you'll ever find success. So I grabbed a story to sell and got ready to raise hell. Then I marched out the door and headed right for the weekly Volcano Press.
Henry Dashwood, now he is a man of taste.
Dashwood was a fiend. He sneered at my distress. Tossed my story high on a stack, but I was determined I would progress. I said, sir, I'll wait while you read, but alas, he disagreed. So I jumped on a chair and read it right there at the Weekly Volcano Press.
You did what?
Keep away from me, you wretch!
I cannot keep away. Your beauty draws me. Your passion ignites me.
It's the one with all the horror in it, the bloodbath.
Yes, that's the one. But I took to heart what you said, and I embellished. I made it better. Lightning strikes, thunder claps.
I've got to have you.
I defy you.
I take you.
Let me buy you. Let go, let go, let go, let go, let go. Then Rodrigo appears in magnificent splendor.
Unhand that woman, villain!
Who are you?
She will never escape me!
Hurry!
On guard!
Go! No!
Dashwood was aghast, but I could not care less. The words I spoke ignited the air. I felt like a publishing lioness. That's when Dashwood started to shout, and I thought he'd throw me out. But then I persevered, and a forest appeared at the Weekly Volcano Press. The forest is dark and scary. Marissa enters, trembling, fearful of what fate awaits her. She comes to a fork in the road and stops.
Which way shall I go?
A hag appears.
I can help you choose, but you must make a sacrifice. Give me something, dear. Those combs are not.
Sometimes when you
the tired old knight some assistance?
I have nothing left to give.
Then give me your time.
My fate awaits me.
Can you not care for me? It's been years since I felt the touch of another hand.
And take my shawl, ragged as it is.
You have completed your journey. Take my sword. It will protect you from your enemies. You may return to the moors. Your fate is in your hands.
Then Clarissa raced from the forest, raced to the moors where she called. I have returned, Braxton. I shall rid the moors of your tyranny. Fight me!
I always knew you'd come back to me. They always do.
Clarissa thrusts. She parries. She backs up Braxton and pins him against the tree. She leaps up onto a craggy rock, her sword swishing and swooshing. Never has she been more determined. She is on fire. Pity she hadn't taken dueling lessons. When out of nowhere, whom should appear but the long-forgotten Rodrigo?
Haja! I have returned, Braxton. I will rid the moors of your tyranny.
Who are you?
I am your worst nightmare, Braxton. I am...
her sister!
Then Dashwood got on his knees, crying, sell this to me, please.
Miss Molly!